Hello, folks who love propaganda as much as I do. Let's chat today about a particular method that is used. It's a logical fallacy as well, but let's just talk about the propaganda style of naming the person who says something or the group that says something in a positive light in order to get people to agree with that thing. And a couple examples, I was just reading from the Bernays Reader just now, and I'll put a link in the description. Really good book, a huge collection of Edward Bernays' work. He was the kind of the father of public relations. And I was just reading a chapter from a book he wrote in 1923, and just so many brilliant things in it. But in it, he mentioned there was a publication at the time called The World, and so people would just refer to it as The World said blah, blah, blah. And this made me think about people's fight for freedom. The People's Republic of whatever government jurisdiction. So the choice by the people who started this idea, this newspaper, this government, multiple papers and governments, to choose a word that insinuates widespread support or a huge entity of all of us. It's the people that want such and such. It is the world believes, the world says that taxes are not high enough and they need to be at 98%. Well, we all know, or back then, if the world was a popular publication, people knew that the world was in fact the name of a particular newspaper, but it also sticks in the brain. It sticks in the brain when you say, the world knows that we need more trees or rocks or manual laborers or whatever it is that the world says we need. Well, okay, I guess so. If the world says it, that means everybody says it. The people are fighting for freedom. Well, who are the people? And this leads into a very common, similar thing that you will notice in the media. You'll notice this in press reports and such. Scroll through headlines. You don't even have to open them. Just scroll through the headlines. And you will see things like, doctors worry that blah, blah, blah. Well, first, if you're an analytical person with an IQ over, I would say 90, 95-ish, you would, anytime you hear somebody say, doctors say that, your first thing that you think is, well, wait, which doctors, how many of them are, do they have any biases? Just by virtue of the organization that they're a part of, or are there any coercive factors that if they say something different, they're going to get kicked out of something that they have to be in order to survive in their business? So you have to ask all of these questions when you hear that. Farmers don't like rubber tires. Farmers prefer the old metal wheels, just the metal on dirt. That's the way to farm. That's what farmers prefer. Well, yeah, if you ask four of them who are hobbyists, but if you ask the typical farmer who has a limited budget who needs to go out and get some earth tilled, no, they're probably going to prefer rubber tires. And so you're going to see this, probably one out of every 10, one out of every 20 articles will be some insinuation that either a large group or an important, trustworthy group, and I'm not even, this isn't even about saying, Bruce Willis says that he is tired of blah, blah, blah. Well, Bruce Willis is a former actor that was famous or something, and who cares? He's not a philosopher. I mean, he might be on the side, just like me. I'm not a full-time philosopher. Maybe he does have some good ideas, but he's just some person. We shouldn't be thinking about him and saying, oh, well, God, I liked his movies. He's really a cool, hardcore dude in those, so therefore whatever he says about farmers preferring certain types of tires or tread or materials used in tires or wheels. No, Bruce Willis doesn't know this. Neither do I. Now, we both have opinions that we can offer. Maybe one or both of us is correct. But our opinions are worth no more than yours unless we make this assertion and then we back it up with evidence. So, whether it's me or Bruce Willis or the world, or the People's Republic of Canada, regardless of who says this thing, look at the thing itself. Find out if that thing has merit. is it, in fact, using your awesome brain with all of your wonderful values, which perfectly match what it is you want? I mean, it's kind of what a value is. It's what you think is important. Look at it. Look at the logic. Look at the scientific method used to achieve it. This is how we should make decisions about things, not just by saying that the people of the state of Utah believe blah, blah, blah. Well, no, not all of them. What percentage of them? And of that percentage, how many are in the top half of IQ? Is it just the voters? Voters are typically, if you take a wide swath of humanity, the top 20% of IQ, of savvy, of world knowledge, the top 20% of people don't vote at all. So you're looking at the bottom 80% of thinkers who are even voting. So if the vote says the people of Utah think such and such, well, they could be very wrong. So don't always believe what you see. Actually, never believe what you read. Take another look at it. Take another think at it. And thank you for joining me in the thinking. Please comment if I'm wrong or if I'm right. Like that too. Look forward to seeing you in the next video.